Ladies and gentlemen, guys and girls, Call of Duty fans around the world, welcome back. This is the Call of Duty World League presented by PS4. It is the CWL Sydney Open number one, and it's been an amazing competition thus far. We have a packed house, and we had 30 teams across the Asia Pacific region converge on Sydney, Australia for what is going to be a stellar weekend. It's already started, and I hope you have enjoyed it so far. We just saw Tainted Minds crush the hopes and dreams, at least for one series of Prodigy, after such a valiant fight. Prodigy were ahead by over 100 points in their first hard point before Tainted Minds, with just skill beyond measure, come back and really, I don't know what they did, there's not really a word to describe it, came back and just crushed Prodigy in that hard point. Prodigy came back later on in the series by winning the uplink, but it all wrapped up with a 3-1. Going into our next series, I am joined by my colleagues Miles and Milboss. Gentlemen, thank you very much for joining me. We just had a very entertaining series, to say the least. And Miles, I mean, you were off sitting in the crowd amongst the hype. What was the vibe out there when Tainted Minds came back in that hard point?
It was a kind of weird combo of tears and, like, you know, the Prodigy fans in the crowd were like, oh my God, they're going to do this. The Giants are going down. This is it. They're going to win the series. And then that lead just vanished. And it was like, okay, sorry, guys. Yeah. The dream is dead.
I was talking to Skits, their manager, and he was just there. He was so nervous. He left for a little bit, came back, and, you know, in that Search and Destroy as well, it was, you know, it started off really strong for them, but they just could not keep it up. And Tainted Minds, well, it's Tainted Minds. What are you going to do about it?
That's our first series of the day in the books, though, guys. Tainted Minds getting their second win in pool play. Let's have a look at the schedule and see what's coming up next. With that loss to Prodigy, it's going to move us into our next series, Rampage versus Validate Red. Then we've got their sister team, Validate Black, going up against Garlic Bread. Oh, love the names. Make me hungry right here. Prodigy Esports. Then we'll be seeing them again go up against the Asian powerhouse of Unveil Nova, your Sony Asia champions. Then a little later on in the day, we're going to be kicking things off with the championship bracket. You know, we've just started things off here, guys. That first series, it feels like we're already later in the day purely because of how much hype there was around it. I dare say there's going to be a lot of hype around this one as well. Rampage versus Validate Red. We already saw Validate yesterday take down the open bracket team Volume. Look, what are your thoughts on this series coming up?
Well, Validate Red, you know, we were giving them the favor going up against Volume Gaming. We know the names, you know, these players have been around for a while, and the guys coming in from the open bracket, sure, they were playing hot, you know, Gaz and Co. They put up a great fight, but Validate just a little too strong. But Validate did drop the S&D, forcing it to a game four in the end, which was a bit of a surprise for me, Milboss.
Yeah, I'd have to agree with you. Just the way that they played that, the Volume squad was, you know, it was very convincing, and I was sort of thinking maybe at some point they'll be able to, you know, bring back maybe another map. Maybe the momentum will carry themselves through to the next map, but unfortunately it wasn't to be. This Validate squad turned out to be a little bit too much for them.
Rampage 0-3 in map count so far at the start of group play, looking to come back, but I want to talk about Validate Red. Now, they've already got their first win on the board in groups. As we know, JTEC, Setsi, Tyson, and Zeppa. JTEC, we've seen him last year as well, come out gunning here, Miles. As you know, both of us cast over this guy. He was a brilliant AR player back last year, and he's been firing this event as well.
Yeah, nothing has changed, Josh. He's still a great player. You know, we saw him yesterday putting up great plays for his team. Yeah, it's a different game, but he's very much the same old JTEC, so I'm pretty stoked to see what he can bring here. This is his first game of the day, so maybe these guys won't be as hot as they will be later on today, but still, super high hopes for them.
Yeah, what are your thoughts of this squad, Milboss? Because obviously you saw them yesterday, took down Volume that came out of open bracket. Congrats to them, by the way, for making it out of open bracket. But look, I think these guys going up now against the Asian team of Rampage, I think they're looking pretty strong. But you've seen both these teams play. What are your thoughts?
Oh, this was one of those ones that I'm really unsure about, because the Validate squad, they did show some weaknesses, you know? They did lose a map, and the only team to do so yesterday who was on stream. So that is going to possibly play into things. I'm sure that this Rampage squad are going to be looking at that, and they've probably watched the VODs back and probably seen, okay, these are their weaknesses. We need to play to that. We need to work out how to get around, you know, some of the strengths and definitely exploit their weaknesses.
Yeah, I actually had a conversation with Rampage manager down. He's in the front row cheering his boys on. I'm sure he's excited to see what happens in this game. But I had a good discussion with him about what did the guys do last night, and it was exactly that. They did go back to the hotel. They put the VODs squads on, they watch their games, they watch the Validate Red series, so they know what they're coming up against. So I feel like they've done their homework. You know, they've put their heads in the game, they've been in the lab for a while thinking about strats, thinking about what could change, because mistakes were made. There's no getting around it. You know, it was the first game on LAN for them here in the APAC region, and bringing the Thunder against some of the best teams in the region is pretty damn tough. Yeah, they've got a bit of catch up to do, James, but I'm feeling good that they can make something happen here today.
I hope so. You know, they're definitely the team that's got the most approved from the two Asian teams that are here. Obviously, Unveil Nova, they're known in this scene to be the best. And Rampage, they are coming into this one trying to take out some of these top AM teams, sort of semi-pro teams from our region. And, you know, they've done all right. They didn't completely bomb out every single map in their series yesterday, but this is really going to be a true challenge for them. See if they can't take a couple of maps, if not the win.
Rampage, obviously, they're currently fasting at the moment. They're hungry for the W after dropping those three maps. Now, I think they can come out gunning, but it is a very strong squad in Validate Red. Let's take a look at the maps that they're going to be playing on and see what's coming up. Obviously, it's going to be the same series we saw last time. Obviously, we're still in round two of pool play, so it's Retaliation Hardpoint. We saw what has got to be one of the best comebacks we've seen in APAC so far, of Tainted Minds getting the W there. James, we saw that map. Are we going to be seeing a whitewash one way or another, or are we going to be seeing both teams here go neck and neck throughout that first hard point?
I'm hoping for the neck and neck. You know, throwback. Retaliation isn't really a map that's known for massive blowouts compared to, you know, Breakout that we saw a lot of yesterday. So Retaliation, for me, is going to really come down to who can rotate early and get complete control of a hill and just an entire area of the map. It's not really that easy to, I guess, get into some of those hills, especially like graveyard, sort of cathedral area. You can lock that down so easily because there's only two choke points you can come into it.
Yeah, I mean, just because there's more, you know, this is a kind of map that has so many cutoff points on those hard points. It's very, very difficult to, unless you have a solid setup, it's going to be difficult for those guys to get long bouts of time at a time. So I feel like unless either team is playing out of their skin and they're really able to assert themselves early on in the game, I feel like this is going to be a very, very scrappy, you know, back and throw affair between both sides. But look, man, anything can happen. It's kind of game, you know, this the first game of the day. One little fun fact, though, is the guys on Rampage actually scrimmed Unveil Nova, their old APAC, their old Sony Asia Champs rivals, and they beat them in a scrim this morning. So I've got a good feeling they're going to be jamming up this one.
Yeah.
Obviously dominated throughout previous competitions in warm-ups on the first day here. We had some practice on Thursday afternoon. I know Rampage went down against Nova, so to know that and keep that in mind, maybe we'll see Rampage just sneak up on them and maybe get the W here. But you know, it's more than just that hard point. Obviously, we're going to be seeing that S&D and then the uplink on Frost. They might get, you know, done in three maps. Maybe the same could be said for Validate Red. But of course, as we set up for Retaliation Hardpoint, I think it's fair to say, just looking at the stats, Validate Red probably the favorites. But I'm looking at Rampage because, Miles, we do not want to sleep on them.
Can't sleep on Rampage. They've got everything to prove here. They've got a fire in their bellies. And I'm excited to see what they're going to bring to the table here. Retaliation Hardpoint is going to be game one. This is the second game of the day here at the Call of Duty Open in Sydney, presented by PlayStation 4. And boy, howdy, Milboss, am I excited to get this started.
One thing we need to point out, or that I'd like to point out specifically, is Tsetse, once again with the FTL jump, not selecting go with a trait. And we saw this yesterday. He just doesn't do it.
I've been looking. I've been paying close attention to the rig drafts so far in the day, and everyone's been pretty on the ball, but Tsetse, dropping it, clearly. You know, you're in the home court, man. You're in the D, and you've dropped it, my man. So what's going on? Anyway, still, we've got a long day ahead of us, and we've still got Championship Sunday. So if you make it all that way, let's make sure that you are choosing that rig as the perk for FTL jump, because come on, guys, the devs patched it. They've done their thing. They've done their job. This is on your screen. That's Rampage, guys. They're getting ready. They're getting geared up. That's Ranger on the corner there, and now transitioning over to the other side of the stage. We're going to be seeing Validate Red. Everyone looking pretty ready to go. This game is almost ready to start. Look, James, early predictions. What have you got? Who are you giving this one to? What's your gut say?
My gut says Validate all the way. It's going to be difficult to really call in the later game. We'll have to see how Rampage start, because if they get a good start, maybe they can just carry that momentum through the whole map. We'll have to wait and see, obviously. We've got the game loading up, ready to go. So these players, they're getting into things. They're focused. They're just, you know, I feel like Validate, just the way that we've seen them composed throughout yesterday and just looking at them on stage right now, they are ready to take it to Rampage.
Well, here we go. Game one, Retaliation Hardpoint. It is going to be Validate Red up against Rampage Gaming. And we're going to kick this one off with Tsetse. as we see crazy explosions happening down by this first hard point, as is per usual. It looks a hell of a lot like a Michael Bay film, and not the best start for Rampage, if I'm honest.
No, there was a double team kill from Ranger because of that car bomb, so that is not going to help Rampage at the start. Validate's been able to get a couple of points on the board early on here, which is definitely a good start from Setsi. He's got a kill already. He's just going to be holding this line of sight through the car window. And he turns around, the game sense from this man, able to find one kill through that. He spots another one down range. Not sure whether he'll be able to pick up that kill, but he's sort of pinched in here, somehow staying alive. Can he get another one there? His teammate's going to help him out, so he doesn't have to do too much. But look at Rampage, they're spawning way out in Broken.
Yeah, tough spawns for Rampage. You can see they're spawning far, far out now. And yeah, the cutoff points from the likes of Validate Red, just flawless. You saw Setsi pick up those two kills as they spawn behind him towards Cathedral, and now he's turning around. He's doing a fantastic job of locking this one down and getting ready for that next rotation. We're seeing these players make their moves. They want to take control of market. That's the ideal spawn they want to be taking here for this next hard point. And there's already a bit of contention. Lobby fights going down. One at the bar. Blue gets one. He gets taken down straight away by JTX. And now JTX already going 3-1 on a 2-kill streak. He's going to be looking now from Plat to try to break that setup they have over the hard point. Skywhite currently sitting in there. And you know, as far as kills go, both teams looking pretty even thus far. JTX, though, great awareness, does get that kill. So Skywhite watching back market. This is an ideal position for them to be in, but he doesn't see that player coming from behind. Poor awareness there as Setsi gets taken down, and Rampage back in control of this hardpoint.
And not only the hardpoint, but the spawns that they want to have for this hill. But there'll be 25 seconds remaining on this one, so Cathedral is the next name of the game. But this hill is very much a money hill. We talk about it a lot. This map in general has quite a few money hills. And Lower Street can be one of those ones that you're able to come back and get a few, like, upwards of 40 points on. And they've done just this Rampage. Validate, they did very well on the first hill, but not enough. And now the rotations are in effect. Zeppa, now on our screen, he's going to be setting up early on. So what's the player who's proning there, able to find that kill onto Graze? Just waiting out for the rest of the contestion from this Rampage squad. But it's such a tight game to start things off.
Yeah, great positioning already from Rampage. They're still in control. Oh, they just lost control of the hardpoint there, but you saw them control market. They had that streak covered, and now they're just rotating around, trying to break the setup here. And Setsi with a three-piece. My good God, man. Someone had his Weet-Bix this morning. Big kills from him. He's going to be continuing now, controlling market. Look, he pre-aimed just a moment there. He pulled it away, and it cost him a moment, and it cost him a second. And now, look, Rampage, they've just flooded the markets. The prices are rising. There's major inflation. There's Apple everywhere. JTX, last man alive. Validate Red holding on to that hard point, but it's going to be a big fight for him.
Yeah, he's got three players from Rampage pushing him right now. He's going to have to fight them one-on-one if he wants any chance of winning this, but he's not going to be able to do so. So there we go. Rampage, they're going to be able to break that one. Validate, that was so close, but not able to keep that one in control. So they're going to rotate now over towards Broken. We can see on our mini-map, one player from Rampage is going to be trying to get that early control here. Ranger, he's going to spot the player. I'm not sure exactly where he is. He gets the smackdown on Zeppa, and JTX goes down to Skywhite too. So Rampage, a perfect rotation. And they've also got the spawns here, so they're going to be set up very nicely on this Broken Hill.
Yeah, nice stuff there from Rampage. I mean, great work there. I mean, still on board with Ranger. He's still got his Flechette Grenade. He's 200 points away from that Trinity Rocket. And here comes the onslaught from the likes of Validate. We'll stay on board with Ranger as he tries to tide the storm and take these players on. Goes down straight away. We're going to have a quick look at Blue, who's also in position, locking that hard point down. No kills for him. Great. Can he make something happen here? He seems to be all alone right now. Gets the contest, shots out, loses the 1v1. JTX comes out on top.
JTX with his squad right now. He's gone 7-for-4, so a decent start from him. Tyson maybe could step it up a little with only 5 kills to speak of. And speaking of JTX, he gets another 2-piece there. And that's just textbook JTX from him. JTX, I should say. But he will get shut down there eventually now. And you look on the minimap, really everyone's all over the place. There's no one with real control right now. They're going to be trying to get control of this hotel halls. And this patio is so key to holding this hardpoint.
I mean, this is a whole new team we're seeing here. Rampage Gaming already cracking over that 100 point up against Validate Red. This is not the same squad we saw yesterday playing the Chiefs. This is already looking very good for them. And, you know, kills across the board. Skywhite had a really rough day yesterday. You know, he popped a 3 in like 7 or 20-something in a hardpoint game. And now already 10 and 11 for his team. He's doing a lot of work for the time there. So a different lineup altogether. But Validate, they will not say die. Keeping it together. Setsi's just got his FTL. He's going 15-8 on a 4-streak right now, and he's hungry for more.
Setsi, as you said, that FDL jump could come into effect soon. He has to stay alive here if he wants to work up towards those streaks. He's 350 away from getting his first. He's supposed to play it through the doorway, not able to find that kill, but Zeppa and JTX, they're going to be alive on the hill, gaining all the points, and that's what it's all about. If you can just delay the pushes from Rampage to be able to let your other teammates get all the objective done, then you're going to be set up for life here. But Zeppa just controlling the last few seconds. They are going to be rotating now once again towards the first hill, which is back on bridge. No one with real control over, you know, specific spawns per se. Validate though, they will get the first few points on this one. Nice shots on towards Tyson from Blue there. And speaking of Skywhite, he's going 14 for 13. He's actually the top of his team. So a good resurgence from him.
God, what a resurgence. You know, he's definitely had a good night of sleep. Maybe he had a nice cup of coffee this morning because he's a totally different player. Ranger actually picking up his third team kill of the game. This is the third time he's killed a member of his team. But hey, look, not a big deal right now. 155 to 113 and rising. Rampage Gaming back in this as they're doing a great job of locking down bridge. They've got those cutoff points covered. They didn't have the bridge outside covered, but great awareness from Ranger. Actually, Blue, sorry. He picked up that kill there on Zeppa, and now still trying to hold on for dear life this hard point. Final 20 seconds, and it looks like they are going to milk the rest of this. You can see on the minimap there, there's a few players from Validate. It's actually Tyson who's rotating around back on through Hotel. He's going to try and get the pinch on these players down, looking towards the new B. Gets the cut off there on Skywhite. Great job from him. Tyson getting Ranger, actually. And then we've got another guy on Plat. Look at this push now. This is a complete turnaround. That hard point was definitely in the hands of Rampage, but the rotation and the cutoff plays was all Validate red, so great heads up play from them. The next hard point, basically all theirs.
Absolutely, and right now Validate have complete control over their spawn that they want from Market. As I say that, I have to eat my words because Skywhite comes in from that exact location. He's going to spot one player and Horse get absolutely drop-shotted, and Setsi there shooting some bodies. He's confident going into the rest of this game here. Once again, patio control can be so influential. Able to spot the player on the catwalk there. Can't finish that kill. So he's just going to back off, allow JTX to stay alive on this one. And one player's just run straight past him there almost. Nope, not quite able to get that kill. Tyson is going to find one around on the staircase, and he just gets absolutely gunned by Blue here. He's going to jump on the hill and get some of the remaining points on this one as we look towards Cathedral, and it looks like Rampage have complete control over the left side of the map. If I bring it up here, you know, the Validate players, they have to push down bridge if they want any chance of getting the first rotation.
It doesn't look like Rampage are in position to take on this push coming from Validate, though. I think Validate will probably be winning this engagement, but let's see how it goes. On board with Graze, he does get a great nade kill there, and he secures himself the Scarab. He's 250 away from the Trinity Rocket, and now, look, kills across the board. 16-16 for Ranger. Blue's picking up the pace as well. We've got Skywhite with 17 kills. On the other side of the board, Validate are outslaying them a little heavy, but that hasn't translated entirely to a huge score lead. And here comes our Scarab. This is going to buy Graze a little bit of time. This is a good position for him to be in. Does hit the hit, but the Tackmask is going to save him, so he's not going to be slowed down there. Here in comes the 1v1. Great job from Ranger, staying alive. Big kill there from Graze as well. Trinity Rocket ready, 25 away from Scorchers. This is going to be looking huge. Can't win the 1v1. No, it doesn't happen for him.
But this is at the point where Rampage, they can probably just think about the next hill. I know there's 20 seconds remaining, so they want to do maybe one final push and then maybe keep someone towards the broken area to be able to set up for spawns there. But if I look on the minimap, Zepp is already there waiting for anyone to push him. No one, though, going to have the balls to do so just at this point. A couple of gunfights going down towards broken, and three players from Rampage are going to push in.
Okay.
He's going to find one.
This is the biggest hard point, I think, for Rampage. They absolutely have to win this one. 2-16 at the moment. This is the biggest hard point they're going to have to get a clawback on this lead. Otherwise, I can see Validate taking this game here. And if they can run this hard point, James, it is completely over.
222 to 187 right now. And Rampage, they're falling behind by quite a significant margin now. Over 40 points here. And Zeppa, he's still got his payload available. That's going to be the active camo. Don't know when he's going to decide to use that one. We'll have to wait and see, but still continuous three-man pushes from Rampage down this bridge side, and they're not finding anything off it. They're not gaining any map control, and they're spawning way out in the back of the map, and there's the drop air play. Not going to be able to find anything from that, and we are going to be having to look in towards the hotel, the middle of the map. It's such a hard point to hold down, but too bad for Rampage. They're going to go down 250 to 187.
And there it is. 250 to 187, game one goes to Validate Red. Rampage just falling short, but you can't say it wasn't a close game. They had a fantastic mid play there, but you look, the second rotation of hard points, this is where it fell apart from.
Validate Red, you know, obviously besting the team of Rampage. They came a long way here to play at the CWL Sydney Open 1 presented by PS4. Gentlemen, thank you for taking us through the action. Rampage put up a great fight. Miles, I thought they were really gunning it in a lot of points throughout that map.
They were neck and neck from the very beginning, and there were a few times where Rampage actually had the lead, and that was unprecedented. This is a totally different team to the one we saw yesterday, where they were on the receiving end of every hard point loss, and it was pretty raw. Like, it was a tough one for them. But yeah, this one, you can see early on, things were looking great for them. The kills were pretty even until about mid-game, and that's just where the likes of Validate started to pull it away.
Well, that's what I was going to say. It was sort of that midpoint where they they just fell off completely, Rampage. It was that back Cathedral hardpoint on the second rotation. They weren't able to, you know, hold it down for long enough to get back into the game. Validate, they were just too far ahead and able to close out in the next hill, being over on that broken side. You know, I don't know what it was about Rampage, but towards the end there, they kept on sending three players, but it was like a staggered three plays. So, you know, down the bridge, there'd be one player, he'd go in, get shut down. The next one would go in, get shut down. The third one would go in, get shut down. Then they'd spawn all the way down in the back of the market. And, you know, you've got another 20 seconds before you can even get towards Broken. It's just not going to happen. You're not going to be able to break it if you keep on going for those 1v2, 1v3 gunfights.
If you've seen the movie The Man from U.N.C.L.E., I reckon Setsi's the Red Peril. He was a man on a mission there throughout that. When he got that three-piece over at nearby on Platt there, it was actually ridiculous, Miles.
Yeah, that's a game-changer, man. I mean, he was in position with the nade. He read that play entirely.
Do you know how hard it is to shoot down a drop bear? And he managed to do it in that play along with a three-piece.
I mean, Josh, thousands of people die every single day from drop bear attacks in this country.
It is one of the most unreported events, usually because they leave no survivors.
No trace either.
Oh, scary things. James, obviously, that's the one map done and dusted. That's going to be moving us into the S&D up next. But look, as credit to Rampage. I really think they did well and probably better than most people expected, to be fair.
Yeah.
But Validate Red, there were some times where they were just shining beacons in the darkness of this very nice studio here we've got. But I really think that in the S&D, Rampage may struggle. However, I'm only going off past performance and not on any kind of juice that these guys have been drinking in the last couple of days. I'm not sure if it's apple juice or orange juice, but whatever it is, it sure tastes sweet as hell.
Sweet as hell. Josh, I've actually got a really good feeling about Rampage's performance coming up in this next one, because Validate, they lost their S&D to Volume Gaming yesterday. And it was a pretty convincing loss. You know, Volume Gaming came out swinging. The gun skill was on point. Their decision making was, mwah! It was beautiful. And I've got the same vibes for Rampage. I feel like they're more of an S&D team. Their hardpoint game, they really struggled against Unveil and Nova in the Sony Asia Champs.
Yeah.
But I feel like S&D is going to be where we're going to see the magic.
Well, we're going to have to see them turn up, because if they don't, you know, you go down 2-0, you have to do the reverse sweep to win, and you got to be feeling pretty demoralized at that point, especially after, you know, you just got shut down in this first map. But, you know, momentum is something that we talk about a lot. After one map, maybe it's there, maybe it's not. It wasn't a super convincing win, so it won't necessarily fill the Validate squad with too much confidence. And hopefully for, you know, the other side of things, they'll be very confident going into the
next
map. I'm
just really hoping here that Rampage can, you know, mince up Validate, add some corn flour, and really make a Validate soup to really fill them up. Because they're hungry for the win.
My tummy's rumbling now, because I think we're all kind of hungry for that win, Josh. And totally right, man. Maybe you can season that with a bit of salt and pepper. I think there might be a lot of salt after this one, depending on who loses. But
yeah.
What are you thinking, James? Because if Validate, they lose another S&D, that's obviously going to be big and probably says something about them that we can see in future series.
Well, you have to. We talk about it all the time as Codcasters. You know, S&Ds win series. They win championships even. And if you can't win your S&Ds with two of them in the rotation, then you're going to struggle. But then again, you also have three of those respawn game modes that you can use to your advantage if you're a more respawn-based team. And, you know, this is something that we've talked about, or that people in general have talked about with some of the Slay-heavy teams in the scene in general. You know, Optic Gaming, they used to struggle a lot on Search and Destroy. Mind Freak themselves sometimes struggle on Search and Destroy. That's probably their weakest game mode. So, you know, even though it is such an important game mode, you don't have to necessarily have it to win series.
Ladies and gentlemen, throwback S&D is going to be game two here on the main stage. CWL Sydney Open number one is exploding. Thanks to PlayStation 4, Astro, ViewSonic, all of our beautiful sponsors for helping making this a gosh darn beautiful event. I was going to say some crazy things there, but I'm glad I held my forked tongue behind my teeth. James, S&D, totally different game. Rampage Gaming, you know, sort of saw them play it yesterday against some top caliber teams. They got taken down. And on the other side of the board, you know, Validate Red dropping the Volume Gaming earlier as well. My gut feeling says that Rampage have kind of got this in the bag.
It's hard to really call exactly what's going to happen. But, you know, this is one of the things where Rampage, they can use this to their advantage. The fact that they are, you know, one of the top teams from their region, specifically over in Asia. You know, we've seen, or we saw yesterday, they played against Chiefs, wasn't it? And you know, they there were some plays that they made against Chiefs that were a little bit amateurish, but they're going up a top AM team, so maybe that will sort of counter itself out, and you know those plays won't necessarily have as such a negative impact as it would against your top teams.
Yeah, I mean the top teams are going to punish you for those mistakes super hard, and it, especially in S&D, when you get punished, you lose an entire round essentially, yeah. Unless you can make something incredibly special happen, if you can pull that rabbit out of your metaphorical hat. But look, it's a big ask, and I think that kind of ask, it's not out of the question. It's not entirely unreasonable against a team like Validate Red. But let's see how this one plays out. We're going to kick this one off with Skywhite. As you see that one zoom. Look at that camera work. Props to you, production. That was insane. That was gorgeous. Skywhite now. He's going to be pushing out through silo. Coming through mid. There's actually no engagements yet, but nades have been thrown by both teams. Shots from Zephyr gets tagged by that stun grenade. Good nade, though. Doesn't mind to find it, but doesn't manage to find anyone. Oh, tags a couple of shots there. Skywhite gets set in the background. Oh. Beautiful shots from Zephyr. Wow. Tied up 1-1. 3-3 at this stage. Oh, Zephyr goes down a Ranger. I thought he had that one. Incredible fight. Validate Red now with the disadvantage. Bomb's gone down. It is now currently. Yeah, this is a good position for the likes of Skywhite and the boys in Rampage Gaming to be in. They've got to get the defuse. There's one guy back. Busts. Shots out. Doesn't manage to get the kill there. JTX and Tyson, last two alive. It's been tied up. It's now all's on Tyson. And he does get the kills. Now a 1v1, Ranger versus Tyson. 10 seconds left on the bomb. He's going to make something huge happen here. He's going to have to go for the kills. What a play there from Validate Red. Wow. They were looking a little beat up at the start of the round. Turned it around, got the bomb down, forced the play. And look at that turn. Here comes the final kill. Ranger put in a tough spot.
He didn't even get a single shot onto Tyson in that final engagement there. And Tyson played that one very well. He was waiting out the time, playing the time, as we like to sometimes talk about. You know, there's situations in Search and Destroy where you just have to wait it out and sort of bait the player into having to make the decision, do I go for the defuse or do I go for the gunfight? And right then, Ranger could do nothing but go for the gunfight. He didn't have enough time to defuse because Tyson could have just easily jumped up and killed him. But we will be going into the second round now. Ranger, he finds a kill there. Oh, sorry, Zephyr does, but he'll go down straight away. And JTX now, last alive with a sniper in hand. This is not looking good for him. He's up against three players from this Rampage squad. One of them is going to find him soon. I didn't catch who that was, but it will be 1-1. And that's the sort of gun skill that we've been talking about Rampage having. They just absolutely gunned everyone from Validate in that round.
Yeah, that was a really scary round. Both teams charged mid, and they kind of dodged each other at first. There was a, you know, the train was actually blocking the view sight from each other. But then as soon as the seconds into that engagement, it was pretty clear that, you know, Validate went down quite early. I think the player running Merc for Validate Red, he basically ran straight into Skywhite. He took two shots to the gut and then a belly punch. You can see his screen all shaken and stuff. He had a concussion, if you will. But yeah, that was a huge win there from the guys on Rampage Gaming. The Titans up 1-1. Bomb now in the hands of Tyson. We're on board with Zephyr. Bomb is now going down at A, actually. So as you can see on your screen, it's been a big push from the boys in red. Validate, they've got two kills already. This is huge. They picked up that guy top green. There's a nice turn there, but Tyson's going to go down to blue. You know, Setsi's going down there. Blue is now up top. He's got a couple of players around him. It's 2v3 right now. Validate. The bomb is down, so they need to get that defuse. Big win there from Skywhite. JTX goes down, so now 2v2. There's 23 seconds left on the bomb. All of it is down to Skywhite now. That was a huge win. This is turn this one around completely. The defuse is currently happening. He's got to get in position. Gets the one kill. Can he get a second? No, the players are charging on through. Skywhite's going to make something happen. 10 seconds left. He gets the kill. Can he get the defuse? He found the bomb.
He's got it.
My good God. Skywhite.
That was close.
He's not the same player we saw yesterday.
Absolutely not. 6 kills already for him. A 3-kill streak and his active camo to work with already.
Oh.
Shooting bodies. He is hyped up.
The crowd loves it, man. We want to see blood. Give us blood. Here's that kill again. Just managing to catch that player. Man, I'm actually surprised Tyson. He didn't try to fight.
Yeah.
He went for the run instead. He needed to buy more time, basically. You know, and it's a very tough decision to make, whether he stays in the bomb or if he engages and pokes, you know, goes for those poke plays to slow down Skywhite. But look, Skywhite, man, there was no fear in his eyes. He charged straight through, 2 kills and a defuse. The man's a hero.
Absolutely. We're going to stick on ball with him, as it looks like his squad are just going to be going for a 1-3 split here. Skywhite, he's going to come in contention with someone in the tunnel. He's going to get that. First blood goes to this Rampage squad, and the rest of his team are pushing up towards 8. We'll swap over to blue here. See where he's at.
It's 2 dead already for Rampage. All snipes happening for blue. He doesn't manage to get anyone. Look, Skywhite is 75 away from his Trinity Rocket, and he's still got that active camo, so he's going to go for the bomb arm. This is going to net him that that kill streak, 25 away now from Scorchus as well. So this is great for the Rampage Gaming guys. It's all on Skywhite. He's got three guys against him, but he has camo and the kill and the payload.
But does he use camo here?
It's early.
A tough decision. It's very early. He might be able to get it again, but then do you want to take that risk? You know, you might start falling.
His bomb's being defused now, so I don't think
he's got to check it.
He's got to worry about that.
Oh, and he has, and he's just going to back off. He's going to be able to do it. He's fully streaked out now. He can just sit somewhere, hide away from the opposition, use his streaks, and potentially defend that one.
It's happening again.
I think it's doing it again, Zeppa. He's on this bomb. He's being defended. He pops camo here, but he's already got the defuse.
No, did he use camo? Did that really happen?
He used camo.
Oh, no. That's not good. That's not what we wanted. It was a bit of a waste. He chose wrong. He had three guys there. They could fight the trades. No worries. Yeah, he did. No, Skywhite used the camo. That's so unfortunate. Look, he didn't use enough of the camo. He's still got a ton of it left. I'm okay. I'm fine.
Skywhite.
It was a big one.
What are you talking about?
It was Zeppa. Oh no, I looked at the wrong guy. I was so excited there. It's completely gone. Sometimes when you don't use the whole thing and you die, you still have a little bit left.
I think it has to be within the first second or something of popping it and dying potentially, but it wasn't going to be there. JTech's now left in a 1v2 situation. Blue and Grays, he's going to be going up against. At least they've killed that key player in Skywhite. I don't know why I didn't switch over to the player. I saw you press it.
He's already dead. It's too late.
The game was like, okay, I know what's going to happen. You don't need to look at the player. You know, he's dead anyway. Just watching the kill cam. Who cares? Well,
there we go. JTech's last guy going down. So that puts the boys of Rampage Gaming up by one. Woo.
It's close, man.
3-2. I wanted to see Rampage come out in the S&D, and they're doing just that. Thanks, guys, for listening. Tyson, the only player alive in the game who's currently got his payload ready. Ranger's not too far away from that as well. And look, Zeppa, if he had a better round, he may be closer. Oh, wait a minute. Overdrive play happening with a Scarab in his back pocket. Tyson's going in deep. He's going way deep. All alone.
They weren't expecting that.
Can he get a second on the player at bus? He needs a little bit of help from his friends. They do actually, they're coming up behind him. He's been tagged. This player's on the bike path. He goes down. That's two kills there for Rampage Gaming. Setsi, last man alive. Ranger's going to be getting the plant now. Big ask for Setsi. He's all alone. Can he win the 1v1 against Skyfire? Yes, he does. Skywhite down. He's far, far away from his streaks. He's still got a nade, though. It's 2v1 Setsi. He's got to get the defuse and the kills. He can do it.
I've seen him win these before. 30 seconds remaining, so he's definitely still got a bit of time. I think he spotted the player there potentially just through that crack in the wall.
Wow.
He's going to get that one there. And now it's a 1v1 against Ranger. Ranger, he's going to contest him here. He uses FDL jump, but he doesn't get away in time. And that's going to be Setsi winning the 1v3 clutch.
Oh,
that is insane.
Setsi, you dirty, dirty boy. Beautiful stuff from him. Three kills in a row. Look, man. I'm actually proud. Ranger, that FTL play, he went for it.
Yeah,
he totally was a salute, 100%. If he didn't salute, we'd be surprised. 100% went for it on the FTL play. Here it is again. This was great, but look at Setsi on the turn. That sensitivity just catches him in the knee. Man, if he hadn't got that kill, that would have changed the engagement completely. Props to Ranger for making that one happen, trying it. Just unfortunate. The map geometry was ever so slightly against him, but still, superb round from Validate Red. Setsi, your damn hero.
And we're going to stay on board with him. He's now got his FTL jump and only 250 points away from that Trinity Rocket. He's going to use his FTL jump, finds the kill, so that's a great use of it. Now in a 3v2 situation, change that down as Setsi is taken out. 2v2, JTex picks up the bomb, and it was down on this A-bomb site. He has to hide from that score streak there. Not going to be able to, and that's both kills from the score streak.
Oh, look at that. Trinity Rocket played to perfection. They fired all three real quick, and then he thrust that last one down to get the maximum splash damage possible. Here you go. 1, 2, thank you very much.
That was beautiful. Ooh, one on one, the other on the other.
Oh, cinematic.
Perfect.
Perfect stuff. Again. Yeah. But also, great FTL play from Setsi, showing us how it's done. He was like, oh, that's how you FTL? Nah, bro, this is how you FTL. Getting that great killer on train. So, round five, actually. No,
round eight.
My bad. The fourth win, Rampage Gaming. I'm sorry, man. I'm first game.
Numbers. I don't
know. I don't numbers. I can't. I need a numbers guy in my life.
Skywhite, he's going to be putting the bomb down. He's still got two score streaks remaining. He gets this one. So, 450 away from regaining those Trinity Rockets again. It's 4v4 right now, but as I say that, Graze is immediately taken down. Here. I don't even know how Skywhite was planning to win that gunfight. JTex getting the better of him. Spots one player around the bus. Can he find that kill too? He does, in fact. And that's going to be all four down from Rampage. Validate, a clean round there, only losing one player.
Look, Rampage, that round, I felt like they wanted to get the bomb down quickly, but I don't think they had a plan to deal with Validate.
They
had the plant, and it was all good. It went down very, very quickly. And now, you know, it's 4-4. The defuse was pretty damn easy. Boys in Validate Red looking pretty chilled out. Very, very composed. No drama for them at the moment. Yeah, I want. Yeah, I'm going to talk about that t-shirt later.
I love that t-shirt.
It's a good t-shirt. It's huge. The guys are on page. They've got everything to play for still. Skywhite's still streaking. He's still got them streaks in the back pocket. He has Scorches, and he still has the Bombardment to play with as well.
So now, if he uses them.
Yeah, we've got Validate on offense. Zeppa's carrying Bomb. Tyson's going 10-6. On the other side of the board, the champion for Rampage is Skywhite, 14-4. Here comes an early engagement mid-map. Tyson just absolutely crushed
Here
it.
Here we go. That's going to be the Scorches. Place down.
Find anyone?
Get any kills with this one?
Here they come. Nah, nice job.
Actually, no one. Yep.
Look, it was a good idea. They had the thought that, you know, they knew there was A side. B was completely covered. You know, we have Skywhite sitting on B, completely locking that one down. But sadly, A just got that perfect, the overpass there from the train line. Just completely covered it. Still, Setsi and Zeppa.
Just Setsi.
No, there you go.
He's done it before in a 1v3 just a couple rounds ago. Can he do it again here? He's getting call-outs from his team. We can hear them on stage. Ranger, Graze, and Skywhite he has to go against. If he gets the kill on Skywhite, I think he's got this one because Skywhite is the key player in this game so far and in this series for Rampage. And we'll find Graze first up. Now, this is where Ranger and Skywhite really need to come together and join forces, but he gets caught in the reload, gets tagged up, and Rampage, they're going 5-4 up. This is map point.
In the words of John Lennon, come together right now over me. And they did just that. Two-man push. Takes him clean out. They'd seen that 3v1 happen before, and they said, please, God, not again. And we're going,
not like this.
Not again. Not like this. Still 5-4. Rampage now one round away from sealing their first win here at the CWL Sydney Open number one. I'm going to drop the number later.
Here we go. Zeppa, he's got his active camo to use, and I think he's going to pop it right now. He does, in fact. He jumps over the opposition players. Can he get anyone from behind? Spots one, so he'll be able to get that kill. It's a 1v3, and instantly finds the second on blue. Validate, they level it up. It's going to be round 11, Miles.
What can you say? Look, when Zeppa's playing, he's making camo plays like this happen. It's flawless.
You saw that shadow. That was beautiful.
Dude, that was, the slide from Zeppa, that was good stuff. I mean, shoot the bodies all you want. It's now round 11, Rampage versus Validate, game two. It is all going down. Round 11 is going to be it. Where the hell do we go from here, James? Well, let's see what these teams do off the break. I mean, look, straight away, it's two men through mid for Rampage. They've got one guy going to B. Here comes the push. It looks like A's going to be the side of the bomb. I'm going to keep that one kind of quiet. There's no death just yet, but nades are out.
Just chilling here. Zeppa just waiting in mid for someone to make a mistake, but there's the bombardment.
Wow,
it's only going to find one onto JTEC. Skywhite also goes down in a trade, so an even 3v3 playing field right now. Zeppa trying to find a bit of cover there. He's going to get traded out as well, leaving a 2v2. Setsi and Tyson against Ranger and Blue with 54 seconds remaining on the clock. And you look at Tyson, he's all by himself over on A. And Setsi, he's like on the other side of A. They've got A on lock.
Yeah, I mean, they've got A on lock, but they don't know where these two players from Rampage are. And the players are coming through. Look, there's a bit of a turn. They don't know. They've actually just walked straight past them. So if we watch Setsi, he has no idea that these guys have come by him. And now, two running in tandem. This is going to be a gunfight, and Tyson goes down. It's all on Setsi. But of all the players to give a 2v1 situation to, it's the last man standing, Setsi. Can he make something happen here? Oh, he's found a player. He didn't kill him. He tags him up, but he doesn't get the kill. And now he's stuck in a wall. My goodness, Setsi! He almost had it. He couldn't finish that kill. Wow. There we go. Ranger. What a final kill to get that one. I think it was him. And the boys from Rampage are going to take that one. Yeah. Beautiful stuff. 1-1 in the series already. Validate Red. They just struggle a little bit in the S&D game. Falling by it short kind of every time. But man, what a game.
That was very, very close in the end. But, you know, Rampage did what I suggested they needed to do in those sort of 1v-whatever situations, is play together. If you've got more men, you know, three people coming against one person, you're not going to be able to get all three kills if they're all facing you. So, you know, that will be how the cookie crumbles. I don't even
cookie
know.
Crookie crumbles sounds like a weird, like, old man band.
Yeah.
Anyway, just either way.
Good.
Dude, look, here's a couple highlights from that game. Highly, highly entertaining, if you ask me. Round by round, we saw some superb plays. Rampage with the win, ultimately. But still, super exciting stuff. James, I want to go back to what you said about, what Rampage needed to do more was just, you know, stack up together. And you know, there's nothing wrong with a couple of dudes holding hands. It is Mardi Gras here in Sydney, so happy Mardi Gras to all y'all out there. Hope you're having a great day in the rain. The parade's going to be lit a little bit later on. this was a great round from SkyWhite. You know, he was the S&D god for his team. I think he finished the game on at least 15 kills. So beautiful stuff from him. And here, Graves getting another sweet win. You know, Rampage, they clutched up when they needed to, except for Setsi. Setsi took that one 3v1 situation. He ran that one home. This is actually it. This is the 3v1. There's the first kill. He manages to pick up this player alone. And this was the great turning point, James, you said. The guys, all they needed to do from here on out was in those situations where they've got the manpower, they needed to just bunch together and make sure that they played the trade. Because when you've got 3v1, you can trade a couple of kills, but do not fight that guy one by one by one, especially when Setsi is fighting so well. His shot was on point. And yeah, SkyWhite again, the S&D champion for his team, fully streaked out very, very early on. Trinity Rocket came into play. The bombardment, not so much.
Yeah.
But look, that was a highlight reel and a half.
Absolutely, man. SkyWhite, 15 kills and 6 deaths. That is an insane improvement from yesterday. I don't know what he's done. And I have to agree with Josh that they've been drinking some kind of juice. Apple, orange, doesn't really matter. Maybe blackcurrant.
Cranberry.
Could be cranberry.
Coconut.
Don't know about
mango.
That.
Coconut Mango's juice is good. Okay. Well, it's like coconut milk, really. It's the milk. But I've always wondered, you know, how do you milk a coconut? It doesn't have nipples. I don't get it. I mean, am I wrong? Can somebody tell me how you milk a coconut? How do you milk a coconut? You don't get a bucket out and get your boots on and just go for it. I would like to know. If anyone can tweet me the answer as to why we call it coconut milk as opposed to juice, coconut water.
Well, it is.
I think that's a branding thing.
Yeah.
But probably. We're beside ourselves now. Guys, welcome back. Game 3 is coming up. It is 1-1 in the series already between Rampage and Validate Red. And it's been a good one. James, it's been a great series so far. Validate Red falling short in the S&D, but the hard point was pretty much all theirs. If we have a look at the scores here, 250 to 187. But James, talk to me a little bit about how, you know, what you felt about that hard point, because we've covered it a little bit. But like Rampage coming close in the S&D, or clutching up in the S&D, but kind of just falling kind of short in the retaliation. How do you feel they're going to be going forward in Uplink?
Oh, God, this is a hard one, because obviously the Search and Destroy non-respawn game mode, it worked in their favor. They were able to effectively trade almost every single time, every single round that they won, at least. Whereas the Hardpoint, you know, being that respawn game mode, they struggled a little bit, but I'd like to see how they go on Frost Uplink, because they haven't played it so far this weekend. And, you know, it's one of those maps that is a favorite amongst a lot of players. They love this map for some reason, and it will be interesting to see if they practice it a lot. Maybe they have. Maybe this is their best uplink map. Who really knows?
Yeah, we got to see. I mean, at the Sony Asia Champs, we got to see a little bit of Rampage playing on Frost, and look, nothing stood out crazy to us. It wasn't like, damn, these guys have got this map down. You know, they've got the blueprints out, and they're planning everything from top to bottom. You look, I've got high hopes for them going into this, especially running off the crazy momentum. Winning a 5-5 round, winning round 11, is just amazing. You're on top of the world.
Oh, of course.
You know, you've just walked across the knife's edge and come out on the other side on top. That is the ultimate way to run into the next game. And it is going to be Frost uplink for us, and we are definitely going to be seeing a breakout on Hardpoint. It's not like we haven't seen a few of those already, James, right?
We have.
Just a couple.
Just a smattering
of breakout Hardpoints.
But, you know, Breakout's a really good map as well, and I feel like Rampage, if they've been watching the VODs from yesterday, they'll know what they need to fix going into today, because that was, as far as I can remember, they did get smashed quite heavily.
Yeah, they've got to get to the S&D.
Yeah.
They have to. They have to get to the S&D. Rampage, I think their hopes here in this game, it is going to go straight onto that Search and Destroy. If they can get to Crusher, I think it's going to be a better place for them. They had some really good numbers up against, I believe it was the Chiefs on Friday. But look, we'll see how this one plays out. Frost Uplink is up next, guys. Thank you for tuning in. Get you to tweet the stream with the hashtag CWL Sydney. It's not quite such a wet and crazy day today, but inside things are getting steamy.
Just a little bit. You know, the crowd's starting to fill in. That's really good to see some people coming in supporting our scene. You know, we've had a couple of events where we've had crowds in Australia, and every single time they prove to be one of the best crowds here.
It's a passionate crowd. Speaking of crowds, I would love to have some of those Call of Duty Astro tags. Shout outs to ViewSonic and Astro and PlayStation for sponsoring the event, guys. Thank you again. They're very nice headphones. Man, I'm still running A50s. I'm a noob. It's the truth.
I've got like literally second gen Astro F40s.
But that's because they're vintage and cool.
Not just vintage and cool, they don't break.
They're retro.
Like, I really want new ones, but the old ones haven't broken yet.
You're one of those guys you can't justify the purchase unless the old ones are dead. I like that. Yeah. James, I respect that. I respect that.
I have the money for it. I'm a uni student.
Yeah, totally. You know, you see some people have got like stacks and stacks of headphones. And they're like, oh God, what do I do with all these headphones? Like, before you give one to me, champ. How about
I'll
that?
Take it. Charity that? Case over here.
Guys, we're almost ready to get this one. Rig draft is underway. Rampage versus Validate Red. Game 3. Uplink on that map. Sorry.
It's Frost.
It's Frost, that's right. Well, you know why it's Frost? Because I'm not a big Frost guy. I know you said a lot of players really like it, but I think because I suck at Frost. I am not a very good Frost player. I'm not very good at running lanes, dude. I just suck at it.
I like Frost. I've played it enough to get into it. You know, there's a certain amount of really good spots you can hold down long ranges of sight, and there's definitely also some shorter ranges of sight that you can get some good, you know, shoulder high cover from and be able to get some easy kills through tight choke points. So it's really going to see, like, I'm actually very excited to see who starts rocking the SMGs in this one, because we didn't see any SMGs in the Search and Destroy. I can't remember.
Oh, no, Skywhite was he was using E-Red. Yeah, he bit. I think he swapped out towards the end of the rounds, but no, he was picking up kills with that. But okay. Dude, 100%, we should see a couple of E-Red plays come out in this one, and I would expect Skywhite to run that. I'm on the other side of the board, you know, I'd probably give that SMG to maybe Tyson. Tyson's been shooting real good, but there's Setsi's MV4 was so on point.
You don't want to take that away from
him. Yeah, don't take that away from the young man.
So speaking of Setsi, once again, the damn FTL jump, he hasn't picked up the trait.
Come on, people.
And Ranger as well, both of them.
I'm not going to be the guy to go over and tell him. I've done my best. I've been shouting it over the
Mike
venue.
can you get someone to just tell them, please, right now?
Please equip Wizard. That trait.
Thank you.
Anyway,
appreciated.
Look, it's done. The perks it's finished. They're going to play at a minor disadvantage. But look, hey man, if at the end of the day when you win it, you're like, I don't even run Power Slide. I didn't even use it.
I didn't even use FTL. Like, I'm that good.
Like, dude, I didn't even use it. I just had it equipped the whole time. Game is almost ready to get on the way, boys and girls. You can see on your screen, that is Rampage. Got to be feeling damn fine after winning that round 11 S&D on Throwback. On your screen there, Blue. Plays big anchor for his team. He's got a great AR shot. Also a big fan of the R3K, which is...
And he's using neither of those. He's using an ARAD.
Oh, my good Lord. That is that's a strange turn of events. But you know what? I like it. I'm a big fan. There on your screen, Validate Red. Still looking good. They know that they've got a bit of an advantage here in the respawn game types. And why the hell not? Things are about to kick off here, boys and girls. Oh, production's doing it again. They know to make this girl happy. It's happening. 3, 2, 1, let's get this game underway.
But this is exciting because Rampage are actually running a double ERAD setup. Blue and I think it was Skywhite both picking those up. Meanwhile, Validate, not a single SMG to be found. Speaking of Validate, they're going to be pushing early into mid here. Setsi trying to find the first kill. Not going to happen. That's the 3 down instantly for Rampage. JTEX last alive in the middle of the map, I should say. Sorry, and he gets a massive 2-piece there, stopping any kind of push coming out of Rampage. And that's exactly what you need from your last player alive.
You can get 3 players down, but as soon as JTEX goes Super Saiyan, the game is over. That's 3 in a row now for JTEX. These kills are big. He threw out the trophy. It was a valid play, but he didn't realize that player was going to be in front of him still. Great stuff here early on. Rampage with the opening gambit, but you know, Validate, JTEX just slowing that one down entirely. The drone is still in mid map. We got a bit of a contest happening here. Big play. JTEX can't stay alive, and here comes Rampage on the run. Skywhite with that drone in hand, he's going to be keep on running through. 7 kill streak for Ranger, dude. When is he getting these kills? And that's
it's not.
It's on the spot. They didn't get it. Blue's got to make it happen. Goal line defense for Validate Red. It could have been a dunk.
Clutch.
It was so clutch. Wow.
I didn't even realize that the drone had moved that far up the map already. Ranger as well with the 7 kill streak you spoke of. Didn't even realize he was getting that many kills, but all of a sudden, JTEX, he's got 3 of his own on this kill streak currently. And he's going to be trying to get on the flank there. One player on crates is going to get the better of him. That was Graze. Right now, Blue, he's trying to get some shots downrange. Not going to be able to find one just as of yet. Of course, the ERAD being quite a close range gun, it's very good at close ranges. Sometimes it can get some long range kills here, but Graze, he's got 2. Can he get the 3rd? Not going to happen there. So no one really being able to get control of the map and the drone in general.
All right, now we've got Rampage on the offensive. Let's have a treat for you guys and go with a listen in to Rampage Gaming.
Nice.
Well, that was quite a treat for us, guys. We not only got to hear Rampage get the points, but we got to hear them be scored against. So now it is 2-1 to Validate Red. They've just got another dunk, so props to them. Validate slaying their little hearts out. 15-6 for Zeppa. He was on a 7 kill streak a moment ago. Now he's on a 10, and he dies. All my fault, Zeppa. I'm sorry for everyone at home. I apologize. He was going to go for 15, but it's all finished. Now Tyson gets that second dunk. It is 6-1. You blink, and it's over. Wow, Validate Red really coming out strong here in the first half.
Tyson, he's trying to get started in this map. He wasn't that hot. 6 kills only for him. He was all right in the Search and Destroy. Did quite well there. Speaking of certain players, Zeppa on his team, he's got 2 streaks to work with here and very close to getting that active camo as well, which is obviously one of the most influential specials that you can run in this game.
Yeah, I mean, the payload, it's you pretty much guaranteed a dunk. You turn invisible, you still hold on to the drone, and that's pretty much game over. Speaking of payloads, that was the FTL used there, I think, by Blue. You notice that when he uses it...
Oh, my God.
Oh, my good God. When he uses it, he actually drops the drone as well. So,
yes.
Zeppa now, he's ever closer to that camo. He's still got bombardment. He's 325 away from his next Trinity Rockets, and here comes a big push. Shots all over the place, and he does get taken down by Ranger. So... beautiful stuff here from Rampage, trying to hold on to that defensive blade. Drones out, Ranger in hand. He's going to be moving back and forth. He needs to, his teammates have got to build that space for him to work with in mid-map. Once he's got that space, he can be able to run this one through. There's 30 seconds left on the clock. A dunk would be huge for them right now, but look at the trap set. It was going to be Zeppa who gets the kill on Ranger, and he's trying to keep it running, but look, it's still in their base. JTX needs to get that one out of there. They need to get that out of dodge. Maybe throw it down the sinkhole there, get it by sub, but they're going for a push. 15 seconds left. Guys on Validate Red want to make something happen here. They want to go for another cap. 2 points would be great, but look at that. Ranger with a 2-piece. He's going to slow that down entirely, and I think we are going to see this one go down. Oh, last chance attempt for the guys on Rampage Gaming. The drone's gone out. He's passed it forward. I don't think anyone's going to have this one. Ranger's trying to get those opening kills. The clock has run out. Not enough time left. Round 1 is going to go down 6-1. Validate Red. First half is all them.
Yeah. And it was a good first half. A very solid 3 dunks. You know, they didn't really worry. Look, every single time that I saw them going for a score, they seemed to just have complete control over the opposition's base, and they didn't have to worry about going for 1-point plays as a safety measure. They could just run in for the dunk, and there you go. 2, 4, 6. Here we are. Rampage, however, they've only been able to sum up 1 point so far. We did manage to catch that in the listen-in, of course, but it wasn't isn't enough to get in the lead, and this is like a mirror matchup from the start of the other half of the first half. Rampage, 3 down for them.
Yeah, I mean, the drone's already in the move now. We've got Tyson. He's probably going to be able to get a dunk there. It seems home and dry, but we are going to have those players from... Oh, no, it's going in. Just a beautiful dunk. 8-1. I was about to call it. The players from Rampage were in position to get
JTX
the defense.
JTX got a 2-piece.
Yeah,
that's
the story of the match. JTX getting 2-pieces. It's been an absolutely spectacular display from him. Tyson now continuing this run. That ERAD has been absolutely huge for him. There are 3 members alive now. That drone is out. JTX with drone. We'll stay on with him as he runs this one through. He's going to have to contest with 3 members of Rampage now on spawn. This is going to be a head-on fight. The sets he wants goes up against Skyfight. Skyfight gets him. Blue goes down as well. Now, he's got to change direction. He's got some help now. Look, it's not looking great. Can he get the one? He goes for the throw, bounces it off the wall. Tough angle to make, man.
Yeah, it is. It's a very tight sort of choke point, that one, especially for going for a drone throw. But right now, Skywhite, he's going to pick it back up here. It is 8-1, the scoreline. So Validate really stamping their dominance on this uplink right now. Skywhite's going to go down as well. He was going for a hit there. Didn't manage to find anything with it. Connection not going to happen there. Zeppa, he's still got 2 score streaks to work with and his active camo available. 29 kills for this man. He's gone huge.
Validate Red on the offensive. Let's jump into a listening with them and see what it sounds like to be on the winning team.
Nice. I'm going to get on this egg glitch.
Wait, slay left, slay left, slay left. Fuck,
I missed that.
Nice, he went ice. No, I got him. One more ice.
More undead.
He got me hard charge. He's dozer.
Those are weak, nice.
Nice, guys.
Wait, come left. Come left, full left.
Nice. I'm playing already, I'm playing already.
Play replay, just can you throw the ball ice?
No one, I'm underneath portal.
Let's get the portal kill. Come on, come.
I'm coming. I'm going through the shuttle.
Come.
Shot camera, is it worth coming?
They're void.
Yeah, all await me cut, yeah?
One more ice. Slid down ice. See that chocolate ice? There's only one. One Tyson.
I can't see him.
Yeah, they could be spawning.
Throw the ball ice. It's fine. He's flanking. I've got him.
One ice. He's weak. There's two with him. One more. No, I said.
I'm on streaks.
I'm on armor.
Alright, let's go.
I got full streaks.
I'm streaking him.
Yeah, do it.
The blue.
Alright, one's in cut. One's on board.
He went ice.
Yeah, they're throwing
connector.
I got him. Yeah, and top blue. I got one.
Top blue's out.
Ice. Ice weak. He's pushing hatch.
Got him.
Oh, behind me, guys. Hatch.
Two, one there. Oh, fuck.
One kills, let's go. I've got middle. Nothing middle. All gone, chip, surely.
I got one here. Two more.
Oh, fuck.
Connector, mid. All way connector.
Main connector.
All good. No worries.
You're gonna slam me. Setsi may have just died there, but the man has been playing out of his skin in this series so far. Zeppa also going 34 and 18. James, you called it. He's a man possessed, and they're showing it here on Frost. There is nothing cold about this gameplay. Camo in the hands of Zeppa. JTEX also has his payload. I mean, we just saw Rampage actually, they deployed the Trinity Rocket. Setsi got one. Here comes that camo play. I mean, that's a guaranteed dunk. There are three players in front of you, but it doesn't matter because you're invisible. How black and white can it be? The man cannot be seen, and he's holding the most important item in the game. That's going to be a guaranteed score. We've got that reactive armor in the back pocket of JTEX as well. I mean, he doesn't really need to use it. He's going 27-16. This game, it's very much been Validate Reds. They've been slaying like crazy, and it's showing in the points. But I take it back. Ranger just managed to get a dunk. So we've got him back on the board. Ranger's actually having a huge game himself. 32-24. He's got three of the points for his team so far. So props to those guys. Rampage, though, falling short on the uplink. The respawns, they seem to be struggling against the ANZ region here. You know, but look, that's why they're here. They're here to learn. They're here to grow and develop, and they are doing just that. 16-4 is likely to be our final score. We're still on board with JTEX. He's just tearing things up. Loses that big 1v1 against that ERO player, though. I think it was Sky White, so props to him keeping this one alive. Graves, can he get a couple more sort of commiseration dunks? I mean, it's all for show now. Still, every second is going to count. I don't think he's going to be able to do too much with this one. Graves keeping the run alive. Does drop to Zeppa, who, let's face it, man, Zeppa, it's been his game. He's almost at the 40 bomb. He's at 38. He's got a little bit of time left, but he won't be making it, guys. Game 3. It is going to be all Validate Red, 16-4. What a screamer of a series.
That was crazy from Validate. And Zeppa, he was a man on a damn mission right now. And Setsi as well, 34 kills for him. He turned up late in the game, especially in the second half where we were having that listening in. I think he got at least 3 double kills, if not more. He just went off. Ranger, you got to give it to him. He tried his hardest, 33 kills, but it wasn't enough. And Skywhite back to his old ways from yesterday. Falling short a little bit here.
Boys, Validate Red. Setsi was slamming in that one. We are now sitting 2-1 in the series. It was great that Rampage got on the board in that previous S&D. Validate Red, though, I don't think there was really a stage there where Rampage had a chance. You know, they had moments of brilliant smiles, but really couldn't piece it together.
Oh, they got the first point. They had a miss. They had one really close missed dunk super early on. We saw them fumbling around the Validate Red goal line, and it was like, you know, super clutch plays from the likes of Validate Red. But man, you got to just close that out. You got to just get to the finish line and just pass through that tape, baby. You can't be tripping up, tying your shoelaces. Still, great stuff from Validate Red. Slayed that one all the way to the bank.
James, what do you really think was the defining difference here? Because obviously the scoreline was quite blown out towards Validate Red at the end of that one. We're checking out some of the highlights from here, including the drop bear plays there. What do you think really set Validate Red apart from Rampage in that game?
Just the slaying capability. It was insane. They all dropped massive numbers. Tyson, probably the least. He only got 22 kills, but the rest of them above 25 kills. Meanwhile, on the other side of things, only one player with more than 20 kills. So, you know, as much as the objective work is what's, you know, very, very important in a game mode like Uplink, still, you got to get those kills to be able to get control of the map and get control of the objective.
Miles, I think along with, you know, just that raw slaying ability out of Rampage, I think it's just really the structure of the pushes. You know, not only did they just down one or two players from Rampage, but Validate Red, they saw their moments. They knew for one or two kills. That person who got the kills didn't always just rush forward. He would set up and get through the dunk or get that uplink with the drone.
Yeah, they seem to have they had much more clarity in their play, Josh. You're absolutely right. When you see the opportunity unfold before you, you got to take it. And I felt like Validate Red, they had a much better sense of when there was a time to strike and, you know, when there wasn't. That's why Rampage were fumbling around on the goal line. They weren't necessarily able to get those spawners killed before they can come in, or they didn't intercept those guys on spawn. They weren't necessarily, you know, pushing at the right time. But look, this is a fantastic learning experience for them. And, you know, on screen, you're watching sets, you go buck wild, getting 7 kill streaks and ruining, man.
Yeah.
But Rampage, look, I'm sure going out of this game, they're going to be learning a ton from this and taking that in every game they play for the rest of their careers.
I completely agree, Miles. They just had vision. It's like they're the spawn of some kind of seer. They knew what was going on and they had the play in front of them. It was just a great composure, and I'm sure that you'd agree.
Oh, look, what can you say, man? Validate Red, it was beautiful play. You don't get a scoreline like that without really knowing what you're doing against a team. You can't just, and that's the thing with uplink, you can't just like hammer your way to a victory like you maybe can in S&D if you're kind of super skilled, or in hardpoint if you basically just plant yourself in the objective and the hardpoint and just kind of kill everything that comes your way. Uplink takes a hell of a lot more coordination.
Yeah, I'd have to agree with that, because, you know, you have to be able to control key areas of the map to be able to actually get any sort of drone movement. And one of the most important parts of that is definitely controlling the spawns, pushing out the team that is defending to some random part of the map, where it be the top side or, you know, the bottom side of the map, trying to just be able to get those lanes to just run in dunks. And that's basically what Validate did.
A great performance by Validate, gentlemen. Those of you at home as well, we are hoping you're enjoying the show. This is the CWR Sydney Open 1 presented by PS4. With thanks also to ViewSonic and Astro. These guys are going to take a little watering break and get hyped up for map number 4. We'll